Hey everyone, and welcome to the 105th episode of We're All in the Same Boat. I'm your host, Luke Roxwell. Today we are talking about Rise of Skywalker, which we know came out a little while ago, but you know, hey, we got into an argument about it last podcast and figured we should cover it. And we're doing it live on our Instagram.
Live.
So right now it's just on my Instagram, Luke Roxwell. We'll see about how this goes and figure out if we're going to do it on like the Instagram for the actual podcast, and we'll go from there. Today I am here with Shayne.
Howdy everybody.
Nick.
That was so awkward, Shayne.
I started saying one thing. I was gonna say something else, like, but I stopped myself. I know. It was terrible. I was hoping I wasn't first, and then I was first.
The live pressure
the live
is so much worse.
Was making me nervous.
I guess Michael's here too, but whatever.
And Michael.
May the force be with you.
Boo.
Oh man. So before we get into the main topic today, which is Rise of Skywalker, which like I said, I know it came out forever ago. A lot of stuff has been going down.
Star
I don't know if you guys have been paying attention to the news.
But it's really okay because you have nothing else to do because you're stuck at home. So
and you might as well review the Star Wars movie. So, but before we get into that, Nick, you said you had an update about the thing that everyone knows about.
Yes.
Coronavirus update. Can you insert music when I say that? Later?
No.
Okay, thanks, Luke. I'm glad you're going to do that for sure. Add it to the Trello board. So, in case you're wondering about coronavirus, please stay indoors because we are currently heading into peak season. So that's my small little update. Unfortunately, numbers are rising across America right now.
Yeah,
so
my small little update is that they shut down the school system in Virginia, and it's crazy. I've seen so many teenagers on the streets, and I can't do it. I need y'all to stay home, go to school, go to class.
Ideally, every state should be on lockdown right now.
Did you say why do they have to stay in? Especially, did you say it was getting to be flu season? What did you say?
Peak season.
No, the corona season.
Peak season.
So like this is.
We're going
through
our
time.
We're starting to go through our peak. Like we're going to hit the top eventually. Like in the next few
like
weeks.
Most people are going to be infected right now.
The mayor of New York said that half their population is going to get the disease, which is 2 million people.
Yeah,
I think it's more than 2 million. If it's
and
New York.
I just want to say for everyone listening, I was supposed to be in New York right now, like my vacation, and thank goodness I am not there.
But so stay safe, stay indoors. Don't go
wash your hands
and wash your hands.
The public service announcement:
wash your dang hands.
Don't hang out with people that are older than you.
It's funny because I was going to travel.
Anyone.
I was going to travel at the end of April, but I touch my face so much, I know I'd be screwed.
They wouldn't even let you on the plane.
Yeah, FYI, if you listen to this episode, the last episode, we actually talked a lot about coronavirus. We're not going to talk about it in this episode because it's all over the place. We did find out in the last episode, though, we talked about in the last episode that we're all learning through coronavirus that we touch our face like a million times. So
Don't do that.
All right. Yeah. So
moving
Michael,
on. Good luck, everyone.
Let's talk about Star Wars.
Boo.
Dude, now I know what Luke feels like every single week.
So
I'm right.
I just want to say,
I just want to tear down your hopes and dreams.
No. Wait, before we start this conversation, just so there's some type of organization and you two are not, or you three are not just yelling.
You already know.
I'm about to
you
go
already
at
know
it,
how
dude.
This is going to go. So you're like, okay, hold on. Before everyone starts killing each other. Yes.
For everyone listening, I have never seen a Star Wars film a day in my life.
What?
Now when I say that, I probably did see one or two of the older ones, like one time when I was a child. I have no memory.
Like, you're backtracking as soon as you said it. You're like, I've never seen one. Okay, maybe I've seen one.
When I say that, people think I have no knowledge of what Star Wars is, and that's not true. When I say that, I just mean I don't watch this stuff, so I don't really know the story and the plot and what's going on. So I watched this film from someone who has not, from a perspective of someone who's never seen the movies leading up to this. So I will say I was completely confused for the majority of the film. So I think for this podcast, I can act like a mediator because I have questions and you guys have to convince me, do I think the movie is good or do I think the movie is bad as a new Star Wars goer. Viewer.
Wait, so did you watch episode 7, 8, 9?
I've only seen the movie we're talking about today. I saw it in theaters. I saw it in theaters when it came out, and I fell asleep halfway through.
Yes.
Naturally, we thought Shayne would be a great person having the podcast. So here we go.
And I watched this one, and I did not fall asleep during this
Let's
one.
Talk about a few things. So
I did doze off for like 10 minutes.
We've been friends all this time, and you never told me this.
I've said this many times.
Hold on.
To start this off, with no knowledge.
In the last podcast, like I said, we started talking. Stop talking, Michael!
I can't. I don't know what to do right now.
In the last episode, we were talking about coronavirus the entire episode. And then at the very end, Michael was like, I don't even remember. I think you said something about Star Wars. And then we started talking about that. And it was like, okay, we got to stop because this needs to be a podcast. So
I literally asked if you had an opinion that I would hate. And then you went into your opinion that I hated. That's how and you hated it.
To be fair, yeah. Luke, your opinion of Mandalorian is horrible. But
I didn't even say what it was. I know, but that's another podcast, is what I'm saying.
Just so Michael does not hate me. Michael, I've seen Clone Wars. I've seen the series. I've played the video games. I own the toys as a child. I just never saw the movies.
You saw the Clone Wars show or the Clone Wars movie?
The Clone Wars show. The one that came on Cartoon Network every day after school.
You had the toys, but you didn't know why? Like,
why?
I was a young boy like everyone else. I knew what it was. I knew it was popular. I wanted to be cool, but I just didn't watch the movies.
That's so awesome.
He's like, I just didn't go the extra mile. Okay, so I want to keep this organized. So we got a lot of notes to go through. One of the things I was going to say is that I hope you guys watched the film again and took notes. But if you didn't, I took enough notes for all of you combined.
I'm actually surprised.
I have over 200 lines.
Really?
Dang.
Of notes.
I have quite a few. Most of mine are questions, though.
He's like, what's the Force? What is a lightsaber?
No, my first question, where are we getting into it? Can we start? Well, this isn't about the movie specifically.
What's it about? Because I want to cover
Wars
the movie just yet.
Okay. It's about Star
Shayne,
Wars in general.
You're
going to
hold this whole podcast back.
No, I'm not. I just want to know.
You're gonna ask so stupid questions.
I just want to know. I said, someone explain to me. Has this war been happening since the 70s when the first movies came out? Is this the same war that's been going on this whole time?
No.
Not really.
Okay, I just wanted to talk about because I was like, wow, this is a long time.
It's kind of odd.
Like, in the 70s when this movie was, and I'm like, it took place a long time ago, Shayne,
in
the 70s.
I know that the film itself did not take place, but I'm just saying, have they been writing the same, like, story of the same war since they made the first initial movie?
So if I recall, this is like 30 or 40 years after that trilogy. And then the prequels were like in the opposite direction 30, 40 years before.
Gotcha.
Or I think maybe less than that. I actually don't know the timeline.
It spans over a large
Mike knows.
Span of time, though.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
I told you guys, I know nothing. So.
Do you know who Han Solo is?
I know he had a movie.
It's like, I've heard his name before.
This is awesome.
Okay. So we're going to try and stay away from questions that Shayne has. No offense, Shane.
No.
You're a spectator.
Before the movie, Shane, I have questions related to the plot. Hold on. So before the movie, all of you did rewatch it, though. Yes?
Yeah.
Yes.
Good.
Of course. I
did
it
all
fun.
Of you guys take notes?
Yes.
I did.
No.
Okay.
Nick.
That's fair.
We're all
trying to like not get sick. We're all at home. You have no excuse not to watch the movie. Before we get into this one, let's talk about The Last Jedi. Now, Michael, I know you hated that movie.
Everyone does. It's objectively bad.
That is a very controversial movie.
Nick, did you hate The Last Jedi?
No, but I didn't
really?
Like it. No,
okay.
But
that's fair. That's fair. That's fair.
That's fine.
Wait,
Shane,
why were you so, why were you
don't
so
need
surprised that he didn't hate it?
It's not a great movie.
But
in
clearly,
opinion.
I hated it because I found no interest in going to see it even after seeing the trailer. So clearly,
yeah, Shane, you said
not good.
So, I think The Last Jedi had a ton of big issues with it.
Oh, yeah.
Um,
viewing this trilogy as a whole
I think,
is odd.
Here we go. Sure. Wait for it. Wait.
I'm waiting. Wait.
I think Last Jedi was a more well put together film than Rise of Skywalker.
Oh, yeah. I would probably agree with that.
Mike. In terms of what do you mean, the story?
I'm just waiting. Yes! I'm just waiting for Michael. I just want to know what
Shayne,
he has to say.
Shayne hasn't seen it, so we're talking
to Mike.
Last,
okay, so
yeah, you can spoil it. I don't care.
So one thing you have to view this movie through the lens of, when it comes to the whole trilogy, is that Rise of Skywalker had to fix Last Jedi.
I get it.
The Last Jedi has so many plot holes and honestly, plot holes, just stupid stuff that doesn't make any sense in the big arc of Star Wars. They had to go in and just like switch things around. So there are some parts that are kind of just like randomly thrown in there. That's just because they're trying to like, hey, this is actually what's happening. Not that bullcrap that happened in Rian Johnson's movie. Carry on.
But I think they had a different director.
That's always the problem. Movies.
And they were planning on having a different director for all three of them. The only reason why they hired J.J. Abrams is because he's the only one that would come back and do it. They fired their director for the third movie, for Rise of Skywalker. And then JJ was like, "I'll do it right now."
Yeah, the original director for Rise of Skywalker was the guy who directed Jurassic World.
Good movie.
Yeah, isn't that crazy? But here's what I want to say. I want to clear a few things up.
Original script, Duel of the Fates. I've read almost half of it so far, and it's an actual sequel to The Last Jedi. And in my opinion,
that got scrapped.
It would have been better than Rise of Skywalker, which is why I disagree with Mike's opinion.
I don't want us to go too far down this road yet because I want to talk about this stuff more at the end. Because we have the JJ cut, we have the actual original script that I would love to hear about because I actually don't know much about it.
Oh, yeah.
The fact that this whole movie is literally a retcon for a retcon because Rian Johnson was like, no, I'm not a fan of this Force Awakens nonsense, so let's undo it, let's break his mask, let's make nothing matter, kill all the villains, and we're gonna make the redhead villain a loser, kill the main villain, let's do all this stuff, let's change it all, let's make everyone a Jedi. And everyone people didn't like that, and now this whole movie is just Disney trying to be like, you know what, never mind. That wasn't right. We're going to start this thing over again and Disney just switch it up. It's insane. It's insane. It's the weirdest movie, especially considering how huge it is. It's such a huge movie.
Was there a lot of backlash that caused them to change it up?
Yes.
A lot of people did not like Last Jedi because it completely erases a lot of what The Force Awakens was.
Yes.
And tries to be, quote-unquote, a breakthrough film in the Star Wars universe.
But it failed epically.
It just becomes a breakthrough poop in the universe.
And so you have... And so that was a common opinion, was this movie's crap. And then there was also the common opinion of, oh, this movie's great because it does this. And
yeah, I still stand by some of the things that I said in the last podcast we did about this, where they did kind of we won't go too much into it.
Yeah. So no, what's the force?
But he was like, he basically, like, what Rian Johnson was trying to do was do the same twist of Luke, I am your father, nothing's the same, this breaks everything, oh man, what are we gonna do, none of us saw this coming. And his way of doing that was, anybody can have the force, it has nothing to do with your lineage. I know you all expected that, but nope, breaks everything.
To be fair, midichlorians is kind of stupid, so I was okay with that.
Like, I mean, anyone having the force isn't a problem. Like, my first theory was that Rey would be a nobody. I thought that'd be cool. But the problem
is... Yeah, that should have been there.
Rian Johnson tries to subvert expectations, but not in a way that's better. Like, subverting expectations only works if it's something better. That's like if your dad pretended like he was going to get you, like... a car for Christmas and instead of get you socks. He's like, ha!
No, it's true.
Expect those socks.
What a great surprise. Burned your expectations.
That's basically what it was. They set up all this stuff in The Force Awakens, like, oh, there's this cool new bad guy. And like, oh, like, mysterious Jedi girl who's like super talented for no reason. Wonder why. Oh my gosh, like this new like world order set up. How's this happening? And he's just like, well, I'm not going to explain some of that. That other stuff doesn't actually matter. That guy's fake. And anyone can be a Jedi. Yay.
Yes, so he did that, people didn't like it, and so what I'm kind of trying to figure out is, I know that in the original script, it was going to continue that story and sort of take it somewhere. What's so weird about this movie is now they're trying to undo that script to make people happy and then tell a story which doesn't even really line up with the original story in the first movie. Like, we'll get into that. Like, Michael, I'm going to go after this film a little bit. But I want to hear what you think, actually, because I do think there's things about it that I get why people like this movie more than Last Jedi. But why don't we just jump into the millions of notes that I have?
Well, I just wanted to ask Mike, do you think Rise of Skywalker, because it had to undo, like you said, a lot of what Last Jedi did. You think it did that well?
I think it did it okay. It's not a perfect movie, but it definitely was good.
I figured that was like more your opinion. Like, you weren't just coming out for it. I am saying this is a bad movie. Like, I genuinely do not like this movie.
Yeah. That's kind of where I'm coming from.
I think it might be worse than the prequels. I think that's how bad this movie might be.
All right, okay, we'll get to that, because at the very end I have like some thoughts on like why I think it's a bad movie.
Yeah, go for it.
Let's start off with the intro to the film. Okay, the text going up.
It's
the
weird.
The first words, the dead speak.
It's weird.
Which is like, okay, interesting. And it's like, Palpatine's here. You're like, wait, what?
Yeah,
none of the other movies. You can tell that this...
It's a shock.
So much of this movie is just trying to fix the other movie. Yeah. You know?
It's not
so
subtle.
It starts off, I think, on Mustafar.
No.
Right? What is that planet that he's on? He's killing people. I don't know why. He's trying to find that little triangle thing.
Volcano planet. So it's definitely not that. It may be Hoth, I guess. I don't really know.
Hoth? Hoth is a snow planet.
Wasn't it a snowy like forest?
No, he's killing people.
Doesn't matter. So he's killing people. He's trying to get that little device thing. Kind of an odd opening to the film, if I'm being honest. I didn't think it flowed very well. But it was... I don't know. It was kind of cool with the slow motion, but it didn't really make a lot of sense. But then we get right into like the cheesy dialogue right off, where he's like, every voice you've ever heard inside your head, just trying to like explain away the Last Jedi. Like, that's pretty much what this whole movie does. You know, the dark side is a pathway to many. Oh man, I don't want to be the only one talking, but I have
to
say.
No, you're good.
Well, just what are we going to get into? Like, we're going to go point by point?
I'll just interrupt you.
That's right. I'll just interrupt you. That's fair.
Well, okay, wait. I need a little clarification on something. It could be very brief. Who the heck is Kylo Ren and who is Rey and what is their connection? Because the whole movie, I'm like, okay, they're talking about getting married. They're clearly lovers. And then at one point, I thought they were siblings. And then at another point, I thought they were just friends.
Okay, are you talking about the old Star Wars movies?
No, he's talking about Rey.
No, I'm talking about Rey and
Kylo. Shayne, here we go. So Kylo is Darth Vader's grandson. He's Leia's son. So Darth Vader had Leia and Anakin. Wait, Leia and Luke, sorry.
Yes.
Leia had...
I do know that part.
Kylo Ren with Han Solo. Rey, as far as we know at the beginning of the movie, is a nobody. They're not related, so they can make out if they want to, and it's not that weird. Only
it's not
it
that weird.
But not legally.
Okay, but did you, Michael,
so they are related, though.
We got to stick...
They're not related, no.
We have to stick to this podcast like people... Right. For the people that understand Star Wars.
Yeah, sorry, I just Shayne. Wanted to... No, it's fine. I just needed just that clarification because it affects a lot of what I have to say.
Did you think... I thought the dialogue in this movie was so cheesy, like 85% of the time.
I didn't feel like it was super cheesy.
Is it not supposed to be?
Oof.
It was supposed to be funny at times, but it wasn't
funny. It was kind of cheesy.
So ships... Oh, go ahead.
There were a couple of parts that I didn't like. Well, first of all, my first two notes are opening fight scene, epic, ew, Darth Sidious is gross. And, the Knights of Ren are walking by and like the stormtroopers go like, goals. Like they just say goals, like 14-year-old girls. Some of it is kind of weird. Also, Poe later on says, I'm a blast it. Which I thought that was kind of funny, but not for reasons why they said it.
Let me say this, actually. I do want to make sure I bring this up. I understand, based off of everything that I read, that the people making this movie, like J.J. Abrams and the people writing it, and the people editing it, had everything against them. Because they had to undo an old movie. They had to try to make the fans happy. But while doing that, also trying to make a good movie, and then Disney is just like down everyone's throats about what they can and
as
can't
Disney
do.
Does.
They're editing things, they're changing things that the director wanted. They you can tell a lot of this stuff is done for like the toys. Like
for sure.
You know, like all of a sudden he puts his mask back together and now it's red and it's like, well, great. Now that's a whole nother action figure
costume
that they can now sell.
That thing's actually pretty cool because it's Disney's kind of like a reference to this like kind of pottery technique. It's called kintsugi. Like they like it's a Japanese piece.
Well,
Japanese
thing.
They
like
they fix like broken pottery with gold, like to fill up the cracks to kind of like show like the journey that the piece has been through. So I thought the part was actually kind of cool.
Yeah, I thought the mask looked cool with like the red, but the whole thing behind it is kind of silly because. So J.J. Abrams directs this film with this guy with this mask. Rian Johnson comes in and is like, forget the mask. And then he smashes it.
Last Jedi.
And then J.J. comes back and he's like, I still like that mask thing. I'm putting that thing back in the movie.
Mask
I don't care if you broke
on,
it. I'm going to make it come back. And so
he
puts it back.
You just got to ignore The Last Jedi. Just ignore Luke. Ignore
I know, but it caused so much issues. Like, okay, let's talk about this first scene. The Emperor's right. there. Cheesy dialogue. It's basically the dialogue in a nutshell is, it doesn't matter why I'm here, doesn't matter what's going on, it's the dark side of the Force, it's fine, which is fine, like it's fine.
Yep.
However, then he like uses the Force to lift 100 million ships out of the ground.
Yes. Oh my goodness.
And they all have Death Star guns.
I
and
love
like
that
what
part.
Is this what
What?
You know, it's just
the entire time.
That's
said,
not
what?
Even like really no. that bad.
I wrote a note on that part. I said when he said I can give you everything, and then the entire empire rose. I said, okay, how can you resist this offer? Clearly, I must succeed in the mission. I like that part.
I don't know. I do want to clarify something. I'm like notoriously known for
hating
giving
everything.
Credit to like Michael Bay, because Michael Bay does do like really good action scenes in his movies, even though his movies are terrible, right?
His explosions
However,
are good.
So, you know, I could watch this Star Wars film and pick apart every little thing, like, well, how would they know how to get there without a map? Well, where do they eat? When does anybody eat? Don't they eat food? You know, like
they
all that stupid stuff where
movies.
It's like, dude, no one cares
they didn't eat
about
or
where
drink
the characters
water.
Eat, right?
Yeah.
But if the movie doesn't make me feel something, then I'm going to pick apart that and the flaws with the logic. Because there are a lot of flaws with the logic in this movie. And then things that just kind of get shrugged off. Like there's 6 different points in my notes where they basically say like something impossible happens. And the way they make it okay is by acknowledging that it's impossible and shouldn't happen, and there, that's it's fine. We acknowledge it.
Like which ones?
So the first one is, well, this one's not exactly a good example, but where he says, you know, like, what is this? He's like, the dark side. That's why I exist. That's why everything's the way it is. But then the second one is, I have too many notes. Hold on.
Yes, you have 200 lines.
Then the very next scene. Where they're flying the Millennium Falcon and just like space jumping every second from like world to world, which I thought was supposed to be kind of like a difficult thing to do. And the way they explain it is like one of them says, I forget, I think it's Finn, is like, that was impossible. And then Poe is just like, well, I did it. So there you go. And then that's it. He's like, you jumped to light speed over and over and over again. That's impossible. He's like, yeah, well, I did it. So, and then they just ignore it and they just leave it.
There is a lot of that, actually.
I mean, it's
now
not impossible,
that.
Like in their world. I think jump to light speed, they can do it multiple times.
Well, I don't
in
think that's
is
Luke's
crazy,
issue.
Though.
Luke's issue is that they're justifying it by saying, well, I did it. Yeah. Just leaving it at that.
Kind of like when Deadpool like makes jokes about bad writing in Deadpool to cover up, like, the bad writing.
Right. It's like, just because you acknowledged it doesn't mean it's okay. Now, Deadpool's a little bit different because that's what that movie is supposed to do. Most of the time, fast paced and like witty dialogue works really well in Abrams films. Did not work in this one for me.
It wasn't witty, and it wasn't so much as fast paced. It was just pushed. So everything is just kind of pushed aside, and you just kind of move from point to point, and there's no bridge in between. You're just kind of there. And so if you watch the first 20 minutes of this film, a lot freaking happens.
Like, so,
if you put it like a web out and you wanted to see like all the elements that happen, and it's like, oh yeah, what was this and this and this?
Well, that's the thing that I was saying.
It's a
like,
roller coaster.
They're basically just trying to cover up for everything that happened in Last Jedi. Because I think Abrams probably had a vision in mind when he started the first movie. And now he's kind of like, well, now I got to kind of bring
this
everybody.
This is like his second and third movie.
So I kind of excuse that, I guess, in my mind, because I understand where this movie is in the real world. Mm-hmm. They're kind of just trying to set up this whole world real fast and then just go right into it.
Now, so
I get that, though.
Why don't we do this? Because
I liked about it?
that's actually exactly what I was about to say. I was going to say, Michael, what do you enjoy about this movie? Because there are things that I think had a lot of potential in this movie, but they kind of failed for me. But what did you guys like about this movie? First of all,
the fight scenes are amazing. I mean, the opening fight scene is super cool. I like how they kind of call back to some of the old movies and stuff. Not that that's necessary. I think sometimes they do a little too much. But there's a scene when Kylo is at a meeting with people and the First Order, and this guy kind of like tossed back against him, and Kylo like forces him like onto the ceiling, like pushing him on the ceiling. Right. Kind of reminds you of when Darth Vader like force choked that guy in their meeting. But it's kind of showing that Kylo is kind of follow the same path, but he's really unhinged, but also super, super powerful at the same time. Kylo does things with ease that like weren't possible before.
I mean, I've always liked Kylo's character. I always thought he was actually really good in the other movies. I didn't think it flowed as well in this one, because I didn't really know what his motivation was.
To own the Empire. Sit on the throne.
I guess, yeah.
Like, at this point, he's kind of lost. Everyone. He's trying to figure out what he wants to do.
He's just trying to find Rey. He seemed very broken. Figure out from there. He seemed like he's had a hard life, and he's very stressed out about his current circumstances. And that's what I got from him.
He's definitely stressed out. And I think that the angle of him and Rey being connected is cool. The like Force chat room. So they were in.
I love
really
that,
cool.
How they did that.
I've always liked that. Yeah, I like that about really The cool. Last Jedi too, was their dialogue. It was actually really cool.
Yeah, like the Rey and Kylo story arc throughout the movie, I think, is probably the best fleshed out part of the movie.
Right.
Because you get a lot of dialogue, you get a lot of emotion.
I think Kylo's character is the best character in the movies.
Oh, yeah.
Like all three
Rey's
of them.
Rey's character is lame.
Just who?
Whose
girl
character?
Super strong for no reason. Rey?
Rey, she has no character. Yeah. Who is she? She is basically the Avatar. I'm watching this movie. I'm like, she's floating with rocks. She's talking to dead people. She can force move like a tank truck. She can dual wield. She can shoot electricity out of her hands. I said, who is this girl? People keep saying she's a nobody. She's got no last name. She's clearly the queen.
Dumb.
Like,
that is the thing that's dumb about this trilogy. So, like, in the first movie she was in, The Force Awakens, she was, like, randomly mega good with the Force and, like, could fly really well, like, on her first time, and, like, somehow, like, randomly knew how to fix the Millennium Falcon.
She can heal people.
She could force control people with their mind.
Yeah. Like, she was doing crazy stuff.
She said, I have to do your training course. I said, you don't need training, clearly. Right. You don't need the training.
You're done.
That part
you
definitely
finished.
Does not make sense. And that's something I've been saying for a while.
But
so.
tell me more about the things you like. I agree the lightsaber fights are cool. Like that fight in the water everywhere, that's cool.
Yeah, the fight on the Death Star is awesome. The music is amazing. I mean, obviously John Williams is awesome, and he's been making this music since the 80s. So there's not much to do here. But even in, I don't know if you remember, but in the fight with Kylo and Rey on the Death Star in the rain. Not in the rain, but with the waves around them and stuff. Like he's doing like these orchestra hits with like when Kylo's hitting Rey's lightsaber while she's on the ground. Like, it has that old school, like, kind of black and white action movie style. It just, the production is awesome. I think the cinematography is good for the most part. Music's amazing. Everything looks really good. Even the CGI is really good.
Oh, yeah, I mean, all the effects
their budget
looked,
was well
looked really good. The camera looked good. The shots, all that stuff. I just think that it has
the
no
story
is soul.
Where it falls apart.
I felt like the dialogue had no soul to it.
Right.
Where it was almost like I was watching someone trying to imitate Abrams' dialogue instead of seeing Abrams' dialogue. You know, like, nothing quite works. I don't know why.
Well, I think that a lot of the...
You know what dialogue really did work, though? My buddy over here, CPO, hilarious. Hilarious.
Wait, when did that happen?
Or 3PO, sorry.
Wait, what?
There you go.
Oh, I thought you 3PO. Were saying... I thought someone... You were saying someone messed his name up. Like, oh, my no. boy... CPO over here, and no, it's yeah, like
I just read it wrong,
dude. So but yeah, Leanne's hilarious. Really funny about fine. C-3PO because C-3PO was like
comedic timing genius.
They were falling in sand in quicksand. He goes, "Will this agony ever end?" And Leanne goes, "My wife." She goes, "C-3PO is still the same gay robot he's been since the beginning, which is fine. I'm not judging him. He's so sassy and like
he is
perturbed, but
he's
also
so funny." And my hardcore. Favorite part is when he said, when I think they were going to like the tunnel and like the rocks fell or something, and the one guy was asking how everybody was, and he's like, "You didn't ask me, but I'm fine."
Exactly. Like that's pretty consistent with his character, even from the original movies.
Oh, good.
So
I definitely giggled a few times, but I like that.
There was an attempt, but it felt kind of like just too much. All the time, just joke after
yeah,
joke
it
after
was
joke.
Over the top. I liked having all three of them together, like Poe, Finn, and Rey. Having them back together was genius.
That's actually something I wanted to bring up.
Yeah.
Okay.
This love triangle thing that's not working out.
I have like 200 lines of notes of things I didn't like from this film, so I have too much to talk about. But when you see them come back, like when Rey and Finn and Poe are all hanging out, and they're like kind of badgering each other and talking to each other,
they had no connection.
It made no sense because you're like, they barely even know each other. Like, we haven't really gotten to know these characters over time. So if you think about
why, Luke?
Hold I'm on. Telling
Jedi.
You
well I know but listen though, so when you watch like the last Harry Potter movie, the thing that is grounding it is you've just seen these characters go through so much through all those movies together.
Yes.
But
yes.
This one, it's like, wow, look how much of friends they are, making all these jokes and badgering each other because they're such good friends, right? And you're like, well, when did that happen? They've hardly been together for all three movies. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. As a person
well,
who
Ray were, Finn and Rey were together for most of the first movie. And then Poe Finn are like bro soulmates. So.
Well, it's obviously been some time between what? So Palpatine comes back, right? How much time is it between The Last Jedi and The Rise of Skywalker?
Well,
they don't really explain if it's months,
I get
years.
It, that you could say that, like, oh, it's been forever, so now they know each other now, but that doesn't mean we're going to feel it, because it's like, oh, they're just friends, and we just have to take your word for it, but we have no idea why they are.
I had no idea that they were friends. I assumed that they were just co-workers on a mission until I started feeling some, like, angst and some, like, some jabs being thrown. I said, okay, well, maybe they do know each other, but I'm not feeling it, like Luke said.
It was like they were just telling you, like, they're friends.
Yeah.
Viewer.
Right.
Oh, Michael, this is going to be a rough podcast. I don't know what to tell you.
I don't know.
Michael,
you know,
do you have anything
else really
you
liked
about
this movie?
It?
I really liked. I really liked the
okay,
little.
The thing is, I do recognize like the silliness in it. Like the deaths are cheap. The two people die basically, and they bring them back to life. Chewie fake dies, and C-3PO fake dies.
Oh yeah. Well yeah, we'll get.
Oh, that whole Chewie thing was like, what was
yeah,
the point?
Yeah, can we talk about it?
Yeah,
let's
stay structured.
That.
Let's stay structured really quick. So like, Rey is basically in the forest training. Okay, kind of cool to see her training. I don't really know. I think like this movie could have been so good if it had started, if it actually had kind of continued what they did in The Last Jedi. Because one of the things I loved about that movie was that she was like interested in the dark side. I thought that was so good. Like, imagine if she kept finding use in using the dark side. And then in this one, she's kind of just good again. And she's not really tempted to use the dark side. Like, even though Anakin's transformation was just out of nowhere, it at least was always going in that direction. Now, I understand that the reason that didn't work out is because the last two films were such a mess. Guys, there's too much to talk about. There's too much to talk about in this film.
I know. Well, I think, Luke, I feel like you kind of missed something.
That's what happens when it's 2 hours and 20 minutes.
In this movie, she kept talking about how she doesn't know who she is, and like, you can tell, I feel like you could tell she's being drawn to the dark side. For one, when she accidentally, like, Force Lightning's the shit that Chewie's on, Force Lightning is a dark side move. So if she wasn't on the dark side, she couldn't do that. I know you know that, but I didn't know. And then, what was I going to say next? Dang it. Oh, yeah, when she's fighting with Rey, she's realizing that she's fighting with, like, anger and stuff.
Oh, Dark Rey, you mean? That evil Rey?
No. I'm sorry. When she's fighting with Kylo.
Yeah, but...
She's realizing that she's, like, fighting, like, dark... Like, the difference between Sith and Jedi's fighting style is also different. Like, it's kind of obvious. Like, Sith are, like, really rage-driven and just super violent and, like, forceful, while Jedi are fighting more defensively. And and like that scene with Rey confronting her dark side self, like she is battling through the dark side the whole movie, but it is kind of like
it's almost like
sprinkled in. It's not like the whole time you feel it,
right?
You know?
Like I'm saying, like there's no arc to it.
Yeah, like there, it's like
if her whole arc was my life will be perfect if I just use the dark side, and that keeps getting reiterated over and over and over again, where she's like, gosh, if I just use the dark side, that will solve all of my problems. And then, like, the Emperor. If I just kill the Emperor, the person who's ruined my entire life, if they really, like, focused on that, when he finally is like, strike me down, you're like, why would she strike him down? He literally told her that she would become a Sith capsule.
Okay, yes.
So why would she do
that? Part doesn't make any sense.
I was just looking at my notes, Luke, and I just looked at that part. I said, I'm so confused. Why does she have to strike the Emperor down to rule? It's a little strange.
Just put him in a cage. Yeah.
There's so many odd rules.
But why is he asking for it? Strike me down and you can have it all.
It's like he's not telling her. He's telling the audience. He's like, strike me down and then I'll become super and going.
You'll care.
You're like, why is he telling her this? Like, that's going to make her not do it. And why is she going to do it anyway? What is the temptation? What does it solve? It didn't make much sense.
I think the worst part of this movie is Palpatine. Him being shoehorned into this movie just ruins the movie, in my opinion.
I don't know. I think they just, like I said, Michael, in the defense of this movie, it was such an awful hand to be given, like the card, like hand of cards. It was such a bad hand to have all the issues with the other films and then trying to fix it. I get that. But it's still a film and I have to treat it like it's a film, you know?
Also, it's a film. It's definitely not perfect. I'm not trying to say it is. It's not like it's not even the best Star Wars movie, but I don't think it sucked. I think it was super fun to watch the whole time.
Fun fact, it's a year after The Last Jedi.
A year after? Oh. Okay.
Yeah. Didn't know that. Can't really tell, but I looked it up. And
it's 1 year after?
Yeah.
But some other cool things, if y'all don't mind me going into it. Like, I get the things you're saying, but also, I feel like one thing they did that was interesting in this Star Wars, I don't know if it's the best thing or whatever, but they definitely took up the violence a notch. Like,
took it up or down?
Up. You see like that spy's head on the table.
Like
alien dude. Mm-hmm. Also, cool aliens are Australian for some reason. We got like Darth Sidious like being all gross and stuff, which is pretty extreme for that. The Knights of Ren fight scene was super dope. Rey and
Kylo
fighting together.
They have regular weapons like swords.
Well, Luke,
instead of lightsabers,
they have weapons in the Star Wars universe that can block lightsabers. Even in episode 3. But I get you.
I'm also sad because we don't get enough lightsabers in general. Oh, so definitely. Disappointed.
There's not enough really Star Wars movies ever. There's always like three lightsabers at the most.
Other thing that I was going to say though is when you toys. Like... Oh, I lost my train of thought. The lightsabers.
Luke's so mad at this movie. He's losing people.
I know. I'm like blanking out because there's too much to talk about.
Some of the fight scenes and the violence.
I like Knights of Ren. I thought that was cool.
Oh, the Knights of Ren. Yeah, no, they kept getting mentioned, and then they showed up, but what are they? And then
you never learn about them. It is kind
of just sort of exist, and it was like, wait, because
me talk about how this movie is dumb. It's not what I'm supposed to be doing that.
But you know how General Grievous just shows up?
Yes, I love him.
You don't know much about him? Hold on. You don't know much about him.
I accidentally turned on the R2-D2 on my desk, and he's dancing.
But you know how he just sort of shows up, but he is a character. All right, I'm going to wait for this to stop.
All right. What is that?
But you know how he just like shows up, and you don't know much about him, but you learn a lot about him, and you kind of are like, oh, I get it. He's this guy. He's this guy who does all these things. He's got this character behind him. But the Knights of Ren, they never say anything. Wait, how long does that thing go?
I don't know.
Yeah, what is it?
Can't you turn it off?
Throw it on a wall or something.
This is incredible.
Can't you turn it off?
We apologize for our live stream listeners who are being very disrespectful right now.
I know. Is it off? Is it off?
It sounds off.
What is happening?
I'm back.
He's been force choked.
Oh, did you take it into another room?
Yeah, I put it in the closet. I didn't even know the batteries. I thought the batteries were dead. I didn't even know. I was just like touched it and then it started dancing.
Okay.
Sorry.
My point is that the Knights of Ren show up. They never say anything. They never do anything. They fight and then they're just dead. And you don't know anything about them. I kind of didn't even realize that they were in the movie, except that they could have been stormtroopers with those little laser things for all I cared. You know, it's like, what were they?
I don't even think that's a problem with this movie. I think it's just a problem with Star Wars. Just these characters that you don't know anything about. Like, from Mandalorian to Clone Wars to, like, episode 4, 5, and 6. They just introduced characters. Jabba the Hutt. Where'd he come from? Who is he? And then he's dead. It's just like, that's just how it's been in the Star Wars universe.
There's just a way to do it. Like, so the scene, the
Luke
random
wants
scene,
to write and direct the next Star Wars movie.
No, Abrams. Not if there's going to be this type of pressure. So when Palpatine returns, it's like the worst scene ever because they're all in a circle and they're like, Palpatine's back. And you're like, wait, what? How do they know? He's just throwing his voice everywhere. And you're like, wait, really? And then Mary from Lord of the Rings just shows up in this film and he's like, yo, it's the Sith for sure. They can clone. And he's like, only Sith can clone. And you're like, wait, what about the Clone Wars? I thought, wait, those weren't Sith. Wait, where is this coming from? And he's like, the Final Order. And I'm like, wait, the final, that's a dumb name. And then he's like, Palpatine has been pulling the strings the entire time. You're like, this movie 100% was written so that it could be translated into other languages super easily so that they could have a giant international market.
Yeah, smart.
That's why they say things like, Palpatine was the evil guy the whole time. You're like, what?
So the random other countries can understand.
Yeah, so they can translate it really easily, I bet.
Do you think that's why the script's so bad?
Possibly. They were just trying to get a bunch of money and then make the fans happy with all the fan service.
Damn.
So what fan service? Because you've said this quite a bit. What fan service?
Honestly, Shayne, there's too much to explain now.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah, like,
well, just name one or two that piss you off.
Yeah. Lando shows up. They show Luke and Leia fighting with lightsabers. There's Chewie.
What?
Getting his medal. Chewie
he's
gets a medal.
That, like, game with him on the Millennium Falcon. That's from the first
movie. They're like, he's definitely cheating.
Han Solo
comes back. Yep. Luke catches the lightsaber.
Luke.
Oh, true.
It's basically everything.
So, that was lame. Yeah.
So is this the last movie?
R2-D2.
Is this the last movie in this trilogy? So whatever comes next is a different story?
Yeah, this is the end.
Okay, so they were just trying to wrap things up. That's why.
If you've never seen a Star Wars, this movie is super confusing. Yeah. Like, Shayne, I feel bad.
Nick, I saw it twice, and I was just as confused the second time. But I think the second time I was more confused because then I was like really paying attention. I said, "Who are you? Like, what are you doing?" Like,
I'm just gonna say it. This podcast episode is gonna be 100 hours long because we're just now at the Burning Man planet.
Oh my goodness!
And there's so much more that happens. In this movie.
It's crazy, dude.
This is the second example.
Sign up for the Patreon.
They land on this planet, which I don't know why they're there. We just happened to stumble on the planet in the place of the planet where there happens to be a party that happens once every 42 years. And he's like, wow, that's lucky. And then they just leave it.
I mean, that could happen.
That definitely looked like something got cut there because they all just turned around.
But it happens so many times in this movie. I wrote them all down. We'll go through them.
Oh my goodness!
The Skype call between Kylo and Ren, I think that's fine. I actually have no problem with those. Kylo and Ren.
I think those are good. That's a good thing.
I mean, where they're talking in the Force world.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And they like grab things from the other world. Yeah, that's fine.
I like how it's that good editing on those parts.
FaceTiming. Yeah, I like those scenes. Yeah, those scenes cool. are actually really good.
Their fight scene together was really dope too.
It was dope. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh yeah. All the lightsaber fights were great. I did like those. Like when they're like pulling really things out of the other worlds while they're fighting. Yeah, I really like that.
Also, Lando showing up was very cool.
Yeah, Lando's cool.
Yeah.
Until he flirted with his daughter at the end, that was awkward. Oh yeah. Wait, Shane, what do you think was happening at the end with Lando and that girl?
Remind me who Lando is.
Lando is the black guy.
Why are you asking Shane? Oh,
the black someone guy knows. Who was like best friends with Chewie.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know. I don't know.
He's like the no offense, no, Shane. He's the worst no person thought. To ask.
Yeah,
in this
like, I have no thought on that.
What did you think? Because like, all right. So at the end, the girl who used to be a stormtrooper is talking to Lando, and she's like, "I don't know who I am." And Lando's like, "Well, let's find out." I want to know what he thought of that. As a person,
well, yes,
about
he was clearly talking about taking her to the bedroom. But
okay, yeah, that's what I thought too. But apparently, he's her dad.
Yeah, I know. Oh, I thought about that.
I mean,
yeah,
that makes no difference. Disney these days, that makes no difference.
Apparently, he's her dad. And what I thought was funny is that she's British and he isn't. And I was like, wait, that could totally happen. Imagine if you found your long lost son and he was like Australian. You're like, wait a minute. It could happen, but it'd be so weird. You're like, where'd you get that from?
But I thought
you didn't get that from me.
I just want to know what Shane thought, like who he was talking to, because he sounds like, I think the problem is just that the actor that plays Lando only has two voices, serious and sexual.
Yeah, he was like, tell Leia, send her my love. Yeah. Whoa! It sounded like he was about to go sing, you know?
And they're like, why didn't you tell her yourself? And he's like, I already did.
Last night.
Yeah, it's super weird.
Do you think he was brought in, like, do you think he was planned to come in, or do you think he was brought in to be like, hey, maybe this will drive
sales? I think he was brought in to try and help.
Oh, really?
He was not contracted for this film originally.
I thought it was planned.
No, well, he didn't do anything. He could have literally not been in this film at all.
Right.
He definitely gave Chewie a sense of purpose and hope and a friend.
Well, I think they just brought him in for fan service.
A friend
and
that won't leave him and abandon him.
Yeah. But I think they would have brought him in just for fan service alone.
Billy Dee Williams, he hasn't really done much. So I was just like, oh, there he is.
Yeah.
And like, no one in my theater responded. I was like, oh, no one cares. Okay.
I know. it wasn't a good reveal. Here's the thing, too. So if we go back to the Skype call, I wrote this down. I said, what is their dynamic between Kylo and Rey?
Yes.
It's like, it's are weird. They lovers?
Yes. I kept
they're enemies?
That the
I
whole
guess
movie.
They are. But you sort of are like, what? They're not friends. They're not really enemies. And I'm like, I guess Kylo wants to kill her because he wants to run her over with his TIE fighter. And then the next second he's like, I want you to join me. And you're like,
and then they're making
but now
out.
He's trying
like,
to kill her again. And they're like, is he trying to kill her? Is he trying to get, I don't really understand it. Like when Darth Vader's fighting Luke, you can kind of tell he's not really trying to kill him because he's, you know, he's just
his
not
father.
Right. You know, he's not like, it just doesn't, you don't know what the motivation is.
My official position is that they are frenemies. And Rey needs
frenemies?
To go do something. Rey needs to complete. I mean, Kylo needs to complete his task, which either involves converting Rey or killing Rey. And Rey just kind of is fighting him, but she also saw him shirtless that one time, so she's down for whatever. That's my official statement. On
that's
it.
Like the only thing they had going.
So she saw him shirtless that one time, and now
it's
she
true.
Can't stop
he's,
thinking
he
about
is
it.
A beefcake, dude. Driver's
yeah,
a beefcake.
Adam Driver.
This is a military man. So then they are on Burning Man planet and they just happen to find the speeder and then he just rips the wires out. Now he can drive the speeder. It's fine. It's not a big deal.
Hot
I get it.
Movies different makes sense.
It's, I was going to say it's not a big deal. The problem I have is that they keep doing things like this throughout the whole movie where it's like, well, we need them to have a speeder.
Boom.
Okay.
Boom,
just have him hotwire one. Like it's just fine. So he does that. Then they're on the speeders. They're just kind of
this movie's on a speeder
flying around, and then that whole chase scene where they're getting shot. And
which
then
one? There's 50.
No, so when they're on the speeders, the other speeder shoots both speeders, and they both blow up in the same way. Nobody gets hurt. They all just fly into the air and they land in the sand pit. that just happens to be next to the ship, and then they get sucked down it. Then they find the guy they were looking for who's dead, who just happens to be in the sand pit that they just happen to fall into, that they happen to fly into after exploding out of a ship that didn't kill anyone.
Yes, it's very just convenient. Like,
and then they happen to find the sword that's there that happens to have the address for the place that they're trying to get to on a sword that happened to kill Rey's parents.
I wrote a note.
You're just
that.
Like, I don't. There, it's very possible that I missed something, but I just was like, wait, I don't understand how this.
No,
this
you
all
didn't,
just
Luke,
seems random to me.
I wrote a note about that. Where is it? Hold on.
It's just a very.
I said it was very convenient that convenient all of this just happened to happen all at the same time, and they just happened to find the exact thing that they were looking for. But good thing my friend 3PO could not translate, because that would have been way too easy.
I know, you just can't
I feel like
do
it. Could have worked around that so much, like, in other ways. They could have at least asked him, like, from his memory, like, hey, where is this thing located?
That was a like, weird was, plot. The whole 3PO plot weird line was weird. It didn't make
you would
sense.
Think that his programming would say, I'm not allowed to speak it.
Right.
Not that I'm not allowed to translate it. You know, which is fine. I actually don't have a huge issue with that plot hole, because it's kind of funny.
It was just an excuse to get him to that freaking planet.
With a little
technician dude. That's all it was.
But
that's all
then,
that plot line was.
This is how you can tell this movie's such a mess, because Finn, when they're drowning, is like, Rey, I never told you.
Okay.
And then he's just like, never mind. And they never bring it up. And then everyone is saying that he definitely was going to tell her that he was force sensitive. But you're like, why would he do that, though? Like, when someone's dying, if I was about to die, I wouldn't be like, wait, before I die, I have a computer science degree. Just want everyone to know.
Oh, wait,
there's
that
no reason.
That wasn't an I love you situation. I thought that's what that was.
We don't know. I mean, he
clearly
thought she was cute in the first one.
Because then they keep bringing it up. They're like, what were you going to say? And he's like, nothing. It's not that serious. But then it never gets talked about. So then what was the point?
The Force sensitive thing doesn't even make any sense, because obviously he's Force sensitive. The Force Awakens, the first movie, I'm pretty sure the reason why he like leaves the First Order. So Shayne used to be a stormtrooper in the first movie.
Mm-hmm.
It's because the Force awakened in him. Like, it's pretty obvious.
Oh,
he and Rey both awaken.
That's what I'm.
Quote unquote,
that's what
force.
I'm saying. It's like there's no character arc.
It's not a surprise.
Wait, so he has the Force and he wasn't doing nothing with it the whole movie.
He fought with lightsabers and did lots of cool stuff. Like, he's been forcing it up out there, man.
But what was he doing? What was he doing this last movie?
I don't know.
He wasn't like doing anything.
The one that happened last time, or the one we just watched?
The one we just watched.
Oh, I don't know.
But he was doing
he
nothing.
The Force, but he just does things so, that like.
He was complaining the whole time.
Let's talk about this knife. Why is
the
address
stupid? The dagger
on
is
the knife.
Retarded.
Oh, and we're not even at the stupid part. Why is it on the knife? And then why is the shape of the mountain in the knife? And
they made
why
the knife
do they just happen to be? It's just like
it's worse, Luke. It's the shape of the. Oh man, I'm not doing very well arguing my side, but it's worse, Luke. This is the main stupid part.
The mountains could change.
The
like,
worst thing is it's not the mountain, dude. It's a piece of the Death Star that's floating in this weird ocean that flows
which
back and
is
forth.
Weak,
Luke, it's like
there's no way it wouldn't stay in the same place, and they would have to be standing in the exact right area to hold up the dagger
like,
to see it. That was.
I feel like this whole
no
movie
way it
is
be
just.
Stupid.
It was very Disney.
It's a it's like just someone on a mountain yelling Star Wars constantly in your face. And it's just really loud in your ear. Like, why is the Death Star here? I don't know.
When she heals that snake thing, the only reason that whole scene is in there is so that she can heal Kylo later.
Yes.
Yeah.
And
Avatar Rey.
Which I'm sure can happen in movies. Like, some scenes just exist to prove something in a later scene.
Yeah,
but,
it sets it up.
But it just doesn't. It's like, oh, she can heal. Oh, okay. And it's just kind of ignored, like, oh, yeah, I just used the Force to heal him. Like, she tells the audience, oh, I used my Force powers to heal him.
So
that's what I did.
They do
and, like, when Baby Yoda does this in The Mandalorian, it's such
spoiler
a big deal.
Alert.
Yeah.
It's such a big deal spoiler because it's never really
if you
happened.
Seen The Mandalorian and, by and, now, it's your fault.
Yeah, but in this movie, it's just like. Yeah,
it's your fault.
I just used the Force to heal him with my Force powers, audience.
So Luke, they do kind of explain that at the end, but not very clearly. Basically, she and Kylo are a Force dyad. That's why they are so like linked together, and they can like
force chat room each other. So like, for some reason, them being connected is like enhancing both of their force powers. So that's why they can do that now. But still, it is out of nowhere.
I know, but it's also not a main plot point. So it's an explanation. Yeah. No, it's an explanation so that they can do what they want in the story to make it end up where they want it to. So it's sort of like this is an issue with Harry Potter. With Harry Potter, I actually don't know much about Harry Potter, but I do know this is true. Yeah. And every single book, she'll just create a new magic thing that just happens to be the magic thing that they need to get out of whatever situation they happen to be in that book.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And so in this, they're like, well, wait, we need them to be able to heal each other so that he can die, but then heal her. So she needs to be able to heal people, but the Force doesn't let him do that. Why don't we like just shoehorn a little explanation so that people can't be annoyed at us for doing it? But this is where we need... You know,
She's not a simple Jedi. She is the Avatar. Avatar Rey can heal.
Like, it doesn't make sense in the universe, and that's the whole problem with this trilogy.
Yeah, it's really random, even to me.
Like, what is this universe anymore? Maybe I don't understand Star Wars anymore. I don't really understand the Force. I don't really understand, like, why are they healing now all of a sudden? Where powers come from? None of it really makes sense anymore. You know, is the Jedi alive or dead? And then, it's just so weird. Like, the universe itself in this trilogy was so discombobulated. I really think Disney ruined it. Anyway. I'm just so mad. But, like...
Disney's fault.
I'm just really confused by so many things in this movie.
Well, here's another time that thing happens in the movie. They leave the little... she heals the guy, or the snake... And they're like, how did you do that? Oh, I just can do that with my super force powers.
You would have done it too.
And so then it's like, okay, that's not a big deal. Okay.
But no,
Then they go up to the ship and they're like, there's no way this ship will run because it's definitely going to not work. And then they just fix it and it's just fine. You know? Okay, what were you going to say, Shane?
No, because I wrote a note down about the healing thing because she said, I just gave it a little bit of my life force. I said, you gave it your life force? I'm like, isn't that dangerous? I said, how do you just randomly do that? And then what? The guy at the end, he did it to them too. He took their life force and said, you can just do that now? Why weren't you doing that before?
Yeah. It's fan service, and then it's just to help explain the ending. She didn't learn
it
either.
She just kind of knew how to do it. Here's the thing. I don't mind her in the first movie using the mind control, because it's like, well, people probably know about that.
She can also mind control,
too. Actually, here's the thing. I heard a point. Watto from episode 1 knew about the Jedi mind tricks.
Yep.
Right.
He mentions it. So you're sort of like, okay. So she probably heard about it somewhere. She knew about Luke Skywalker. She knew about the Force. So she probably heard stories about people doing this. So that's not... And she's a prodigy. Like, she's able to do it. Okay, fine. That's fine. But in this movie, it's like no one has ever healed before other than The Mandalorian, which came after, didn't it?
I think chronologically... Blah, blah, blah. Chronologically, it happens before. I think it's
between... No, but I mean, when did the movie come out?
Or the show the movie come out? After Yoda. After Mandalorian debut.
Okay, anyway,
it
doesn't matter.
But
after Yoda.
No, but the point is that, like... She can just do it, and it's just kind of shrugged off as like, oh, I can just use that power to do that. And it wasn't ever learned, and it's just sort of in the story. It doesn't have a purpose. So like when Baby Yoda heals, that is a huge thing, and it's a whole part of the story. We've never seen it before, and everyone in the universe kind of acknowledges that, and that's a reason. In this, it'd be like if someone used the Force to just teleport and didn't even acknowledge it. You know, like just like boom, and like went somewhere else and just was there now. You're like, wait, that's never happened. Why is that all of a sudden okay? And they didn't even acknowledge it, you know?
Yeah.
Oh.
Shaking my head.
This is the whole podcast, just me yelling.
Can
we all agree that the Force doesn't make any sense? Can we just agree on that?
Yeah. And some people get the Force, like the overpowered version. They get like the $59.99 version of the Force. And some other people get the $29.99 version of the Force. Yeah.
That's how it is. That's life.
I mentioned this earlier. Kylo tries to kill Rey by running her over with his TIE fighter.
Yes. And what was that whole thing?
Because just for like, no reason.
Wait, I feel he's something. I'm going to go stand there and stare for 20 minutes say, Michael? Waiting.
He's just angsty. He's just doing things to be emo.
That scene is cool.
Yeah.
But you're like, wait, so is he trying to kill her?
Yeah, why did he shoot her?
Yeah, it's so confusing. He was trying to kill her. That's what the guy said. He said, kill her and the empire is yours.
No, I think that happens later because I think I wrote that down in my notes.
I thought in the very beginning he
that's at the very beginning.
He wants her to kill him, but I'm yeah.
That was my first note.
Oh, yeah, and then that's the other thing. Palpatine says, I want you to kill her, and then she shows up and he's like, I didn't want him to kill you, I wanted you to live or something. You know, I'm like,
it was well, part what of if he killed her?
4D he's chess. Sending mixed messages.
He knew that he wouldn't. That
she, I think he was trying to get them to kill each other, and if they were both were dead, then he could reign.
All right.
Oh yeah, and then he crashes his ship at 100 million miles an hour, and it's like rolling, and he's just fine. He just gets out of the
unscathed,
ship, and it's fine.
Unscathed.
I was just gonna say, yeah, no, that whole thing is just stupid.
Like, he was like a baseball; it was spinning like a thousand, just boom, yeah. And he's just fine. He just gets out. He's got no scratches. He's just fine.
He was, yeah. What the heck?
But that's the point. The only reason that was in there is because it was really cool, which it was.
Yeah.
But it just was like
fill time. Yeah. They're just filling time.
You know, her using the force on the ship. I like that idea. I love the idea of her accidentally using the lightning.
Yes,
and that being cool. a very significant thing. In fact, I wish that she killed Kylo later with lightning, and not with the lightsaber.
I thought you were saying she wished she actually killed Chewie, because I was like, me too. Well,
because that then she killed him with the dark side of the Force, and that would kind of make a little more sense, I would think.
Mm-hmm. I think Chewie
actually
died.
She did kill him with his lightsaber, so isn't that kind of similar?
I think Chewie like actually dying would have actually been interesting.
Oh yeah, dude, they keep on cheating us with deaths. They did the same thing in Last Jedi. Actually, no, not gonna talk about that. But yeah, that's a Disney problem right now. They can't let people just die.
They can't.
No,
it's not fan favorite.
They didn't even let the audience think he was dead long enough
they showed
for
they
us
didn't.
To resonate with
him.
The characters that were sad that he was dead. They weren't even sad. I wrote that
they
in my note.
They weren't sad.
Like, nobody
they moved
was
on
sad.
So fast.
It was like Chewie died, and they're like, no, and they're like, oh, we gotta go. And then they were just in the ship, just hanging out, and they're making jokes
about
C-3PO, and it's like, dude, Chewie just died. And then you showed us that he didn't really die.
Just
and it's like
along.
The characters knew. Guys, this movie is just a mess.
It's the four Avatar read Chewie's mind,
ranting.
She knew.
This is the messiest movie since Amazing Spider-Man 2.
Oh, goodness.
That's not fair.
It is such a messy movie.
The messiest
I don't even
movie.
Remember that movie.
Amazing Spider-Man 2 was awful.
That's the one with Jamie Foxx, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And
but the only part I remember about that movie,
yeah,
though, we're not
some of the parts
it.
Of Rise of Skywalker aren't super like logical, but it's mega fun to watch, man. The battles are super. I guess it's just the battles. You got to just take it the battles.
Well,
and
it's too much of a movie to rely on just the battles, though.
Yeah, well, even like because the way
you can
know.
Dissect
I
every
for
part
me,
of
I
it.
I looked at the way that. Oh, sorry. Go ahead, Ben.
But I was just saying you can dissect every part of it, but a lot of the complaints of The Last Jedi is that it wasn't fun. And Star Wars, and people are like, well, what is Star Wars supposed to be? Is it supposed to be fun? Or is it supposed to be a good movie? Is it supposed to be all of these things? And I think The Force Awakens was focusing on what The Last Jedi was lacking in terms of fun.
Mm-hmm. I
so a lot of these scenes don't make sense, but they're fun to watch, and you can enjoy them and turn off your brain. And I think that's kind of what this whole movie was
going
for.
I didn't think it was even...
was fun.
I didn't think it was that fun, though. I think because I didn't care about the characters.
I think it's because you're
and
going
it didn't
into
have
it,
like
thinking about
well, no,
how
it's I
know
it's like
no,
how
I,
you go in
dude,
to watch a movie.
I liked Force Awakens. I liked The Last Jedi. Like I enjoyed those movies. I liked watching them. And then I looked back later and saw a lot of the flaws. But I liked watching those movies. You know, even I liked Force Awakens more than well, that's not that big of a stretch. A lot of people liked Force Awakens more than The Last Jedi. But like the dialogue in The Force Awakens. It was quick and it was witty and it flowed. There was a lot of jokes in it, but I thought a lot of them worked. You know, like when Han Solo shoots the bowcaster thing and he's like, this is that you use. He shoots. He's like, I really like this thing. It's kind of hokey, but it was so fast that it didn't feel corny. It just kind of was like a funny comment. And then when Kylo finally takes Rey, it actually feels like, oh man, he got her. This is insane. This is serious. I never felt that for Rise of Skywalker. It all just felt flat to me.
Right. And it's partially because, you know, they're rushing so much that this grand climax that's been shoehorned in doesn't matter to you.
Well, my issue, well, not my issue, I guess, but what I would say about the movie and why I think it's not completely well done, because for me, I got the sense that this was like an end of a trilogy movie, which obviously it is, but, and it was like the end of this epic adventure. So I'm thinking we're just going to be thrusted right into it. We were not thrusted right into it. Why are people chilling? Why are we floating with rocks? Why are we drinking coffee? We're chilling right now. Are we in the midst of this grand thing that's happening? So I thought we were just going to be like thrown in, flying, shooting people. We're invading, all that good stuff. That wasn't the case. So we had this slow kind of build getting to where it was interesting, which is why I fell asleep in the theater.
Because but it wasn't. This, it, nothing see, here's the thing,
interesting
though.
Is happening.
It wasn't even slow. It was like,
not like
it was
slow.
So fast paced, but
there was just a lot of like, maybe to me, like filler stuff or some scenes just went too long that didn't even need to be there. We're having all these dramatic stares for what? They're not working. And there was not really any too much, like Luke said too, not too much care for the characters' relationships and dynamics, so I was never really rooting for them. They didn't really seem like, I mean, Finn kept saying, we're all in this together. It didn't really feel like we were all in this together.
Yeah, it just felt
we're all stuck on this one mission together, just complete it so we can go home.
So, we'll try and get through some of this, because this is going to be
I also don't like that Finn's one scene with any type of emotional depth with a conversation with another black person. Disney, that's racist.
So this episode's already an hour long, and we're halfway through my notes, and I'm skipping a lot of my notes. But I'll try and see if we can just go through some stuff really quickly.
Well, we've already hammered. We don't have to go through every detail. Well, we
you don't have to drag
like,
the entire movie.
I'm trying to go
parts that
to
we
the.
Didn't like.
I want to get to the main points.
Luke
so,
like, all right, now let's talk about the costuming.
I'll go through some of my notes really quickly. Where is this thing? Where are we? Let me scroll through all these millions of notes.
There is one part that I do want to talk about.
Oh, like the... Gosh, yeah, we just have to skip a lot of this. Okay, so the random girl that you only see her eyes, she shows up and she's like, I want to see your brains in the snow. And he's like, so you're still mad? And then she's like, I'm digging myself out of the hole that you put me in back when we knew each other. You're like, this is it's just an explanation. And that's it's like, audience, this is what this character is supposed to be like.
We're going to tell you.
Then she's just like, she's got a lightsaber. She's a girl. We're friends. And now they're friends. You know, it was like, what is the point?
She
could have not even been in the movie.
Luke, the whole point of her character was to give them access to the ship. She could have just given them access to the ship and we could have skipped the blah, 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 blah.
All right, so C-3PO, his memory gets wiped, but then he dies. I loved that idea, but then he just doesn't die.
Yeah.
And they literally tell you he won't die because they're like, wait, doesn't R2 have a backup of you? Don't be crazy. That's impossible. Definitely won't work.
And they said he didn't, right? And then he did.
Yep.
Wait, what?
They said R2 didn't have a backup, but then he did have a backup of his memory.
And so they killed him, but not really.
This movie sucks, guys. Gosh, I'm just... That is the epitome of this movie.
That is the epitome of Disney coming in saying, no, this isn't going to work. This is not working. We need to fix this. The kids won't like it. They won't watch.
Because I remember reading about something like Rogue One was reshot like in its entirety 6 months before, or like re-edited or something.
Yeah,
like,
I've heard a lot about Disney, these Star Wars films.
What Disney execs have done. Like, I do wonder, like, if this wasn't Disney and this was under Lucasfilms and they had complete creative control over what they wanted to do
totally
with Star
different.
Wars, how different it would have been.
Totally different.
It makes me sad. But that's just like the epitome of like, why did they fake us out like that? Was it because they didn't think kids could handle the deaths of C-3PO, or that it would affect maybe like action figure sales. Like, it kind of pisses me off.
Pixar movies and Disney movies get really intense with death anyway. Like, every single Disney character's parents die in the beginning.
Right.
Why not
kill off C-3PO? Or why not kill off Chewbacca? Like, it's...
You can't kill off the funny people.
They kill off Han Solo, right? And that's what made Force Awakens. Everyone was like, whoa, did not see that coming.
Dude, when they kill Han Solo, I love that scene.
Right.
The way it goes silent, and you're like, you know what's about to happen. And I really like that scene. Everyone's like, dude, I hate it because he dies in such a stupid way. I'm like, I don't know. He died by his son. I like that scene.
I really like that scene. So
let me do some bullets. So Kylo lets Rey know that her parents weren't nobody. Definitely a huge retcon. Like, no, they were nobody because they chose to be nobody. And it's like, dude, just because what? You can't just choose to be nobody. They're Palpatine's children. It's just like Luke's like, oh, I'm just nobody. No, you're Darth Vader's son. You can't just say you're nobody, and then that's true that you're nobody, right?
Yeah.
You know?
Right.
So they killed her parents. Okay, I get it. They're trying to undo that movie.
Ooh.
The one guy happens to be a spy, and he's
I love that scene.
He's like, shoot me in the arm, or they'll know. And I'm like, wow, that's an explanation. And then they just know, and he just gets shot anyway. How do they know? And they just knew, and...
Luke, it was obviously a fake injury. He's like, oh, it was an ambush. They told me to take you to their ship. Yeah, with that little tiny bullet wound and your little bandage. Yeah, sure, man.
So Kylo works for the Emperor now. I don't know why. I don't know what he wants. He just sort of exists. Does he want to kill Rey?
Is he
trying to avenge? No, he's just trying to be like Darth Vader.
Wait, because who?
Kylo. Like, why is he working for the Emperor?
He's evil.
Because he was told to.
So they go to the knife place. I'm trying to get through these because these aren't as big of a deal. They go to the knife place, right? The horrible national treasure scene with the knife.
Knife stuff.
Finn is force sensitive, but he has zero arc. There's nothing, no point to him.
There's no point.
Big scene. Rey fights her evil self in Kylo.
Mm-hmm.
Cool scene. Love the lightsaber.
Yep. Which part was that?
I love the lightsaber. There's like a girl that had a double lightsaber that like folded while she was on the Death Star wreckage.
Oh, yes, yes, yes. That was evil her. Okay.
The only reason evil her?
I was wondering who that was. Actually, Michael, who's this random person?
Michael, what do you think of some of this? Because I'm going to rant. I'm sorry. This is all going to be.
Even when I saw Dark Rey in the trailers, I didn't really know if it was supposed to be her or not. Because she kind of was kind of different. So I didn't even know for sure what they were trying to say. That part was kind of random.
Like,
she just fights a dark side version of herself for a little bit, and then she stops. Then she fights Kylo. She must be so tired, by the way. I bet her arms are really sore.
I said that. People are so stressed out and tired.
They don't eat. They don't rest. They just fight forever.
She's an avatar, so she doesn't get tired.
But so she fights. She fights evil Rey for no reason.
For like 5 minutes.
And then she's just gone, and then she fights Kylo.
Fans,
and it's
Luke.
Like,
she did
dude,
it
you
for
could
the
have
fans.
Just made her fight Kylo. Like, there was not really a reason for that, other than it's like, oh, no, it's like Luke fighting Darth Vader in the Yoda planet.
Right.
But
you must
that actually had
blogs.
A reason, because it was like a foreshadowing of you kill him, and it's like, wait, it's you. And you're like, wait, what is this? Like, there was a significant reason. And this evil Rey, it's like, oh, it's because she's becoming evil. And you're like,
Luke,
why?
You miss all the emails from the 15-year-old Rey stans who said, we want to see her fight her evil self because it represents when a woman is transforming.
Okay.
Feminist movement. Clearly.
So they literally spell out exactly what Leia's going to do with that old alien girl. She's like, Leia knows what she must do to reach her son. But it will take all the strength that she has left.
Oh, which
okay, just
nice.
Tell
she
us.
She had no strength.
Yeah. And it's like, oh, it's like they literally had to write it in there. So it's like, just so you know, that's why she dies.
It's so dumb.
I was confused about that. Did she just make herself die?
Yes.
She did what Luke did, I guess.
Yeah, it seemed like it.
Well, oh, yeah, and then Finn.
It was communicating with Kylo, like with her last bit of energy left.
Right.
So she's like, I'm going to talk to my son. And then she just kind of... was like,
she's fighting Kylo, and then Finn shows up. He's Rey, and then she's just like, no, and pushes him back. I'm like, why is she pushing him back? And it's like, is she trying to fight alone? Is he going to get killed? Why is he there? Yeah, there's no reason to have him there.
He's trying to like save her.
He's always following her. He's like,
yeah,
always chasing her.
Because he clearly cares for her, but he won't say it.
They could have just easily just had him not there. There was no reason to have him there. Because then in the next scene, he's not even there.
Right.
Why, and so then Kylo gets lightsabered and then she heals him, which, okay, fine. Then she leaves.
She felt bad.
And then Kylo turns good. But why?
That was so random.
Because he talked to his dad.
I know, but that could have happened at any point. There was no, like, there was no...
But he also hurt his mom. And so it was just like a triggering that happened. I'm not saying it's good. I'm saying it was just because both of his parents, he realized both of his parents were gone. He was like, what has this given me? Kind of thing.
I guess, but you didn't, but they didn't tell that story.
Well, it's just,
it was just like, he's just good now.
He's emo Kylo. He wasn't, because he's just like a kid the entire time, if you really think about it.
Pretty.
All right, this is nitpicky because I get the symbolism. But why does he throw his lightsaber away? You're like, that probably could be useful.
Yeah, that was dumb.
I get the symbolism. But what?
Yeah,
I wrote down when it went after he threw his lightsaber and went near the end of the movie. I said, I know Kylo Ren didn't show up to save the day with no weapon because he just gave up his lightsaber.
Yeah, when she transports the lightsaber to him, you're like, yeah, because he got rid of the one he already had that he could have been using already.
Right. Also, like, I just realized Kylo totally beaten this guy with the Force. In the first movie, he was stopping lasers with the Force. Like,
he gave it all up.
He didn't even need a lightsaber to beat those dudes.
Yeah.
He's a boss.
That was the old
Kylo.
How does he
beat him? Doesn't he shoot them later?
No, she gives him the lightsaber.
Wait, Mike, I want to acknowledge, Mike, I feel like Mike has slowly started to fall out of love with this movie. A bit.
Because I had so much fun watching it, man. Like, it's so cool. I love lightsaber fights, and I love, like, the drama, and I love, like, well, not necessarily the drama, but I love, like, the way the music and the cinematography all work together and look super cool.
But it's like, I can understand that. Like, I'll say this. I have another good point or a good thing about this film. When Leia dies and Chewie finds out.
That was, like,
pretty,
the most emotional
That was pretty heart-wrenching.
Scene. Yeah, that was the most emotional scene of the movie by far.
Yep. I think that's it. I think it's the only emotional scene.
Well, I do think it's cool.
Right, so. Leia, hold up. I'll let you go in a second, Michael. So Leia dies, and then Chewie, the furball, reacts to it, and he's like really heart-wrenched and sad, and he starts crying. Like, you feel that, because you're like, oh yeah, Chewie had this really close relationship with Leia. Mm-hmm. So seeing him, like, that was the one of the few moments in the film where I felt something.
Gosh,
finally!
We were supposed to feel something from this movie.
Shame.
And then after that, I guess. How do we get to? It's a final battle that's about to start.
That has a 100 million.
Like, this
Star
is the most
destroyers
epic battle
with
I've ever seen.
Star lasers.
Pretty anticlimactic.
It's just like I thought, like, it felt like a 5-year-old, and like the 5-year-old was like, you know, the Death Star. Well, now we have a million of them, and they're small. And you're like, they're small? How do they make them small? Like, it's like, I thought the Death Star, like, they're building a Death Star in the newest, in the sixth movie, and it's like taking them forever because it's like, it's such a massive weapon that it takes a lot of work. And now they're like, no, we have a million now.
I mean, technology does, like, advance exponentially every
you're like,
time.
Moore's, isn't that Moore's? Moore's law?
Yeah, I forgot what it was like. It like doubles on itself every single time. So
cool. Well, okay, yeah, sure. But can you admit, at least, Mike, when the ship's coming out of the ground, that was kind of cheesy?
Oh, I loved it. I'm not gonna lie. I was like, yo, that's sweet, God.
Dude. And then they're on the land, and then Mary is like, wait, they are. What does that mean? And then Poe's like, it means that they have spaceships with planet-killing weapons. Every single one of them can blow up a planet. You're like, oh my god, this is so awful.
Yeah, it's like when someone's weird.
But the last battle was like pretty dope.
Well, I was just saying, when someone goes into a battle simulator and just goes all out on each side and then watches it happen, like, that's what this battle felt like. Just imagine, like, your biggest battle and then double it and then triple that.
Yeah, you're like, more explosions. And you're like, that doesn't make it more dramatic. Now,
turn the
Michael,
explosion knob up.
Here's an example. So in The Last Jedi, when she light speeds through those ships, it's the most insane, coolest thing ever. But there's a part of you like, wait, but you can't just do that, because then why didn't they just do that to the Death Star? Wait, what? Couldn't she have just left the ship? Wait a minute. Well, yeah, it was cool, but what? You know, and that's what a lot of things in this movie feel like, where you're like, well, yeah, it was cool seeing the 100 million ships, but how do they have 100 million ships?
Because of the technology that they had for years, for some
exponentially
reason.
Exponentially advancing.
It's not supposed to really make sense. It's just supposed to be there because Palpatine is the unstoppable force that needs to be stopped now. And it just so happens that he's got, you know, the greatest army on Earth behind him. And also, he can... Can we just acknowledge the Force lightning in the air? Can
the
we just acknowledge...
Blue beam to the sky.
Which part? Where he's like, shoots. I will kill all of you. Yes, amazing. Epic. I love it.
He's like,
yes, exactly. I'll just do it myself.
I remember tackling in the theater, just over, like, losing it when he just shoots it up in the air. Like,
it was great.
I feel like I'm watching a movie like Sharknado, you know, where it's just like ridiculous things are happening.
You know,
I'm
what
like,
made
this
it funny?
Is so ridiculous.
You know, well, what made that part funny? It's because.
It's not Sharknado. That's a little messed up.
I can't think of another film, but like another, like
the
an 80s film. You know,
it?
It's like an 80s.
Yeah.
It's like I'm
it's
watching an Arnold
film,
Schwarzenegger
sure.
80s film where I'm like, whoa, wait a minute. He's just, oh man, okay, so that's over the top.
The part about the lighting that was funny to me is the fact that this whole movie, he's like, kill me and you can rule, right? And then he gets the opportunity to be killed, and then he's like, know what, never mind, I'm going to kill you, and then after I kill you, I'm going to kill everyone.
Well, the fact that he just shoots
that's
lightning
a, well,
and he destroys
quickly.
Like, okay, so in when he shoots lightning before, he kills, he zaps his face, he kills Mace Windu, he tries to kill Luke, but then in this movie, just out of nowhere, he can shoot lightning and destroy a million ships.
Technically,
like where
he
was
did,
that?
He did take both of their life forces to do that.
And then suddenly he's super strong.
Oh, that's a fair point,
yeah.
Actually.
But
that
how
is
did,
a fair
he
point.
Is how did he get their life force again? I don't
because
know.
Because it's a new it's new
and
meta.
Then
it's new
he
meta.
Steals, he steals their life. This is nitpicking, but it also is really stupid. He steals their life form, and that somehow turns his clothes red.
Oh yeah!
Ooh,
or,
yeah!
Like,
yeah,
what?
Clothes turning red.
I noticed that
his clothes turned red.
You got like a red outline.
I don't remember that actually.
Yeah,
it wasn't like the whole
maybe
thing
he was
red.
Just glowing dark energy.
Just little parts of it.
Yeah, he has like red
oh,
in his
no,
clothes.
Even,
that he didn't
even
have
his eyes are red too, right?
Well, it's fine if he changes. But,
yeah. Okay. His clothes.
But his clothes. Like, why did the Force change his clothes color?
You gotta keep
oh, yeah.
the wardrobe
I guess
updated
it is,
with
I
the
guess
times.
It is red. You're right. I'm
it
going,
is, yeah.
Sorry, I'm going through. I have the movie. I'm going
oh, yeah,
through
Nick
it.
Didn't so, watch the movie. He's watching it right now in real
what?
Time.
No, right, I'm,
so let's so let's keep going. Let's keep this stuff moving. All right, so Rey is a Palpatine, and Luke catches the lightsaber.
Whatever that means.
It's so weird. Like, well, because like they're battling, right? Like Rey is battling with Palpatine, and then Kylo Ren comes out of nowhere. And there, he's just mowing everyone
well, wait,
down.
All right, wait, let's not go there yet. Let's
wait,
not go there
wait,
yet.
Wait.
We're still talking. So like, Luke catches the lightsaber. So Force
yes.
ghosts can now
oh,
hold
sorry,
things.
Because we were talking about the Force lightning, and I was like, I thought that's where we were. We
right.
Were.
So we're almost there. And so like, basically, let's just acknowledge it. Luke catches the lightsaber as a Force ghost. He also Yoda
a,
set fire
like a,
to the tree.
Yeah, it's like a middle
movie.
Finger. Middle finger to the
yeah.
Last Jedi. Like,
right.
Here's your lightsaber.
Fine. It did. It literally felt like this whole movie
but
feels like a boyfriend who cheated on his girlfriend, and now he's like getting
yeah.
her flowers
aww.
And chocolates and like trying to make her happy. That's what this movie feels
but
like.
The chocolates and the flowers are like from like CVS, like some great stuff.
My issue with that ghost lightsaber scene
is great.
That it's not that it's not great. It's that there's a whole like war happening, and she's just like, you know what? I'm done. Over it. Not doing it.
Yeah. What was
I'm
that?
Just gonna give up my entire
I'm not
life.
Doing it.
And then he's like, what are you doing? There are people dying, and you need to save them. So I need you to get it together.
you put, you know, your big girl pants on.
Oh my and gosh.
Be the like, Jedi okay. that I made you to all be. Right.
So Rey is a Palpatine. We see Leia and Luke fighting with lightsabers. Kind of love that. Thought that was really cool.
That was fine.
But then something got ruined. You want to know what it is?
No.
Leia stops being a Jedi.
Oh, yes.
Because she knows if she stays a Jedi, that Kylo will die. So she stops being a Jedi. He becomes evil, and he dies anyway.
Anyways.
So it's just like, why was that a thing? Like, she saw the future and was like, I don't want this because of the future. And it happens anyway. And so you're like,
it was just convenient for her to what? Be like, oh, well, somebody else will continue my journey. And here's this girl to continue the journey. Just convenient.
It's awkward too because Carrie Fisher died. So they're, you know, her plot line that almost just doesn't make sense and it's fine.
Yeah, which I can't fault them for that too much. Yeah, you know?
I just kind of let it go.
They should have killed her. Oh, this sounds terrible. They should have like let the character end in The Last Jedi. It almost
when
did.
When they blew her up in space, right?
Yeah.
Like she should not have floated like an alien.
You know what? I didn't even think about that. That wait, she was dead.
Guys, I have too many notes.
I didn't think about that. She was dead. Yes, like, why are they never showing her on the movie? They keep showing her from a distance. But she wasn't there.
All right. You guys ready for this? I'm going to bullet through this part, okay? The dialogue scene before they get in the ships to go fight. He's like,
oh, yeah.
They can't tell which way is up. So that's how we'll defeat them. Because the ships that are crewed by thousands and thousands of people can't tell which direction up is. They actually say, tell which way is up. So we need to destroy their building on their ship.
I don't remember that. I know they had to like destroy their building, 100%. But I don't remember that.
I remember them flying off, standing on top of these ships, not falling off somehow.
Yeah, cool. And then they're riding horses. It's just like, you can't just rotate the ship and throw them off.
This movie's amazing.
I had to remember.
This movie is 5 out of 5 stars. This is amazing.
I had to remember that they weren't in space when that part happened because I said these people would not be breathing, aren't they? Shouldn't they be dead?
I forgot about that.
They're not in space. They're just really high in the sky for some reason.
Okay,
yeah, that's right.
So the last scene, like I know Nick, you said you want to try and get going here pretty soon. We'll try and wrap this up. The last scene.
We're just waiting
with
on Luke.
The Sith. I know this is literally just me ranting, you guys.
I did like the scene where the rebels landed on the wing of the Star Destroyer and are riding those horse thingies and like just wreaking havoc. And there's like cool stormtroopers with jetpacks and stuff. There's a red stormtrooper for reasons I don't understand, but it looks really cool. Like, that was a cool scene. To be fair.
It's cool.
I had
but
a great time.
It's just kind of there though.
If you love the movie, if you like watching the movie, then that's all you can ask for, right? Like if you enjoy the movie, then that's it. I can't get past the issues with it to enjoy it. And I don't even think the issues are why. It just doesn't, I feel nothing watching it.
Well, because you know, there's like a moment at the very end where you're like, there's like a, oh my gosh, like, are we going to make it kind of thing? And you already know they are. And the entire movie also, like,
I never felt that suspense.
But yeah, Poe, Rey, and Finn are just kind of superheroes that kill everything.
If you
notice that, like, they're just mowing down people left and right.
Yeah, that's one of my biggest problems with the movie. There's no stakes. There's no suspense. There's no fear for anyone's life that matters.
So they're riding on this Star Destroyer, and I'm just like, okay.
Well, you know,
they have the Mario star in Mario Kart and just going full force the whole time.
running through, everything's just dying
around
them.
Let's talk about the scene with Rey, Kylo, and Palpatine. So Palpatine wants Rey to kill her, and you see Rey being tempted. But I feel nothing because I'm like, why is she being so tempted? You know, if the movie had set it up, is that her whole life was ruined because of Palpatine. Her childhood was ruined because of Palpatine. All her friends are dead and suffered because of Palpatine. Like, if they showed that, and it was like her getting angrier and angrier and angrier, and now he's there, and he's torturing or hurting the one person that she has left, and then she's sitting there holding the lightsaber, thinking about it, trying to decide what to do, that would make more sense. But it's sort of like they play it up like this is this difficult thing for her, but there's not really any reason why.
Right.
You know, it just, there's just, it's not there. It's, you know, you could make an excuse like, well, he's going to lightning everyone and all her friends are going to die. But it's not there. It's the motivation isn't there.
No, it's not. No, no. Stakes.
Yeah, there's really no stake. And like that idea, the idea is that somehow Palpatine's going to destroy everything.
I like her transporting the lightsaber.
He is, Nick. He has 1,000 Death Stars.
Palpatine can't even move more than 5 feet without
getting crippled.
He just
put them all in a circle facing outwards and just shoot, and the universe would be destroyed in seconds.
I'm tired of Death Stars.
Palpatine's a little bitch.
I'm tired of Death Stars, people.
Just every single one is Death Stars.
Get a new ship.
I wrote this down. I said, Palpatine steals her life and his clothes turn red. Probably to sell toys.
No one wants to buy the Darth Sidious toys.
Probably to sell toys. Yes, you can get the regular version or the Life Force stolen versions.
With red eyes. All right.
That's going to be an extra things, $5, kid.
Guys, we're so close. We're so close. Okay, so all the things in this movie that I think are cool get kind of ruined. The Jedi talking to her is so awesome, but why aren't they there? I wanted to see them. Imagine if they showed every single one there, like as a Force ghost. That's fan service. And they didn't even do it. I heard they even filmed it.
Oh, really? Maybe in
and
the DVD.
And then they cut it out.
I thought the scene where she's talking to all the Jedi from before was cool. Like, that should have been like the big reference to like all the movies. They didn't really.
You should have seen Mace Windu. You should have seen.
Yeah,
Liam Neeson.
That's what I was
you should have seen
say.
Them.
Yeah, that should have been a big reference.
They're like all
like,
alive.
The voices was cool, and but I wanted to see them.
No,
all.
Luke. If they showed Mace Windu, everyone would be confused and be like, "Why is Nick Fury in this movie?"
Honestly,
all the Disney fans.
I remember seeing like pictures of all like, the older people. Like filming and stuff, and I said, "Wait, I even know some of these people, and then I don't see them. Where are they?"
Well, yeah. So
and they were not there.
It's almost like you know I said earlier that this film, a lot of the dialogue is like they wrote it so that it could be translated into other languages. It sounds like when you take like a Japanese movie, and then you translate it to English, and they say things, and you're like, "What? Like ha ha ha! I have beat you. You have fallen on the ground, and now I will kill you." You know, like
that
kind of thing.
That reminds
she
me, Luke,
says,
remind me of
up.
My plug at the end. Just
okay. She says, there's like this big dramatic moment where she gets the other lightsaber and then the music's building and building and building and all the Jedi are talking and it's getting so excited. Then all the music stops and she goes, I am
all the Jedi.
You're like, no, what?
Yeah, that was corn. Corn.
Cringe.
Cringy corn cheese.
It's just so bad.
But it would have been cool. But it would have been cool if they showed it like the Goku, the Dragon Ball Z reference, like the where they do like the father son Kamehameha, and the spirits are like behind them and stuff. It would have been cool like that. And then she was like, "I'm all the Jedi," and then you see them all, and then they defeat Palpatine.
When she
together.
Puts the two lightsabers together, cool.
Whatever. People have like, been dual wielding for years. That's not impressive.
But I didn't understand why she was suddenly more powerful with two. I don't understand the Force, guys.
Yeah, because it was when she put, it was almost like the Force showed up, and then it was like, oh no, it's not turned on until
I put
the lightsabers together, and then it was like. Now he's gonna lose, you know. And it just didn't make sense.
Why after your life force shot taken,
Kylo flies off a mountain
and survives,
and then he's just climbing up the mountain
with no like, life force. By the
Kylo
way, remember
ran,
with no
I,
life force.
What, like I said, Michael, I said this before. They can do stuff like that. I'm fine with it, but they just do it in this movie so many times.
They do it.
He didn't have to fly off a mountain. They could have just slammed him into a wall or something.
He didn't
have
to fly off a mountain.
Okay, and now the worst part of the film. Everyone agrees. Everyone agrees. Yep. She brings him back to life.
So stupid.
And they
my
kiss.
My goodness. What is this Romeo
no
and Juliet? Romeo and Juliet.
It's because she
what
saw him shirtless that one time,
heck?
Luke. That's it. He's been wanting to just see what it's like.
I
annoying. I'm pissed.
There was a time where I was going through Twitter and purposely looking for anyone that liked Raylo just so I could block them.
Raylo.
I was so mad. I was so mad at the whole Kylo Ren Rey thing. I was just like, I can't believe anyone likes this. This is so horrible and bad.
I know. Apparently JJ Abrams didn't want it. But here's the thing. But Disney was like, we have to do it. So the very last thing in my notes, last thing, here it is. Okay. We're almost done, you guys. We've almost made it. I'm going to go take a nap after this.
It hurts. The Rey burn.
Kills Palpatine and then goes back home and buries the lightsabers. Or does she not go back home? She goes to Tatooine for no reason. Oof, buries the lightsabers somewhere. On Tatooine for fan service. And then sees the two service. Sons for fan service. She doesn't go to Jakku. She doesn't hang. She just goes back to Tatooine for no reason. And then asks her, what's your last name? She says she's a Skywalker. Okay. Kind of get it. But
no.
And then she sees the two sons. It might as well have just said directed by Walt Disney Studios because there's no way that J.J.
Abrams edited by Walt Disney Studios.
There's just no way, dude.
Star Wars.
It's like da 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 da. It just says Star Wars.
I am Rey Star Wars.
We fixed the Last Jedi. It's just like that's what the text says. Michael,
did you like the last line? Did you think the last line was good, or did you cringe? Like,
that was the Skywalker line.
Like me, it's not too bad.
Jedi? I am all the Jedi.
No, oof. I am. No.
Rey Skywalker.
I am Rey Skywalker.
Oh,
I was just kind of
mixed feelings about it. I mean, it's always awkward when someone just names himself to some random person. Like, that's the weirdest way to like show their identity.
That laughed in my movie theater, like cackled, like, really? Like you could hear it.
That would have been me too. One guy just
literally walked out. I saw him walk out like he was like, nope.
I'm over it.
That's how this ends. Okay, nope.
It was kind of cheesy.
I would have liked it a little better if we didn't see them standing right there, and then she didn't look at them and smile and be like, "Yes, I love you guys. I'm a Skywalker."
Yeah, it felt
it's just too much. It's just like, okay.
Because you're kind of like, you don't really see a lot of attachment of her to them.
No.
You do a little bit, but about them. You're sort of like, it's so disjointed. This movie's such, it's just
when so disconnected. When it was called Rise of Skywalker, I said, why is this movie called Rise of Skywalker? I said, I see no Skywalkers like doing anything in this movie. And then when I found that about like Kylo kind of, I said, oh, but then when he rose right from being knocked off, I said, that's why it's called Rise of Skywalker.
And then that's the Rise of Skywalker I've been waiting for.
That was it. Guys, I gave myself a headache talking about this.
You probably gave yourself a headache. I just want to imagine, I can just imagine Luke watching this movie, writing these notes. Because if you guys don't know, people are listening, Luke started the movie and in 6 minutes in, he already had 50 notes.
Dude, I it's literally so many notes. Because I just wrote down anything I thought while watching it.
Yeah.
Man, we covered a lot of them, but we didn't cover all of them.
On a scale of 1 to 5, what would you guys give this movie? 5 being the best, 1 being the worst.
I'll say a 4.
What was that? 5 out of 5?
1 yeah, out of like 5 yeah. stars. 1 yeah, like 5 to
stars.
5.
1 out of 5 stars. How many stars?
Yeah. 5 being the best.
Well, here's the thing. I can give them a little bit of grace because I know what they were trying to do and they had
don't
such
give
an
any
awful
grace.
Yeah, no grace.
I would probably give it like 1.5 stars.
Ooh, holy crap.
Like, I'll give it, it's got the fan service fine. It's got some cool stuff, but it's Nick just such a mess.
Dude, I was going to give it 2. Holy crap.
Dude, 1.5 stars, that's a 30%.
I thought about giving it a 3, but maybe 2.5. I might give it a 2.5, but 1.5? Jeez,
Luke. It's a pretty rough movie, man.
I'd probably give it a 2.25.
A 0.25?
A 2.25. Like, it wasn't, Shane. Like, the story itself, let's just be, the story itself was like, it doesn't seem like it's that climactic. For what I feel
remember,
is supposed
folks,
to be going on.
Shane
yes,
has
remember,
not seen
I haven't
any
seen
stuff.
Any prior movies, so I don't understand all of the circumstances. But even so, I still think every movie, if it's a good movie, should be able to stand on its own, and I should not have to see 1,000,001 movies to see if it's a good movie or not. I do think, you know, it was shot pretty well. The budget was pretty well spent. But like Luke said, my Amazon
follow the instructions in your Alexa.
Yeah, Alexa's mad about Star Wars.
She was like, I really like that movie.
I like that movie.
Die.
But Yeah, the dialogue just was, and this for me, because my favorite thing about movies is the characters. The characters were just not there, lacking in personalities, like the main, not personalities, but like together, their dynamics together and their personalities, like the main three, just wasn't really feeling it. And so that gave me no, and Rey, no offense to her, I was not rooting for her in any type of way. I didn't know what she wanted, what was her whole goal and ambition. She was just doing what she was told. You need to go do this thing. All right, I'm going to go do it.
I Dude, am dang. Thinking about, I want to update. I think maybe I could give it 2 stars because I think back on like, well, they were just working with such a rough... They basically like working with nothing, you know. It's like the first movie
less than nothing
just existed, and the second movie just existed, and the third movie just existed. They're 3 completely different movies that don't really tell any story, and they're not connected at all. And it's just it's insane that's what happened.
Yeah,
They still made $1 billion.
The fan service, fine. I see how people can like it, but it's a pretty bad movie, I think.
I still give it a 4. I think. 4 out okay, of 5. Here's the thing, man. I've seen this movie twice now, and yesterday I was watching it, and I was having fun the whole time. Like, I was watching the movie, I was like, oh, that was cool. I was like, oh, that's kind of goofy, but that's what Star Wars always does. They're always goofy.
Yeah.
Like, it's got a kind of goofy thing. The point of it is to go across the universe and meet new characters and see new planets for kind of no reason, and have lightsabers happening. There was a lot of lightsabers in this movie, which I thought was great. The fan service, I don't really care about fan service, but I appreciate it, like... I appreciate when they call back to an older Star Wars film just to like contrast, like they do with Kylo a lot. But I don't know. I liked it.
You know, I said I'm not going to make fun of Mike. I'm not going to cut him down. No, wait,
Mike,
I'm not here to hurt him in any way, shape, or form. Physically, mentally, emotionally, spiritually. Mike. You're wrong. Just accept it.
Well, Michael, is it a 4?
Look. If you like the film, I'm glad you liked it. I love it when people can enjoy a film. I just don't. I didn't like it at all.
Let's clarify. Yeah. Michael, is it a 4 in terms of like you were entertained by the movie or like the quality of the film?
That's a good point. It's a 4.
Because it could be a good movie, but I enjoy a lot of bad movies. Yeah. I love bad movies.
Well, I didn't enjoy it ironically. Like, I wasn't like, oh, it's so bad, it's good. Like, I had a lot of fun, but there are a lot of holes in it. And a lot of it's due to The Last Jedi and then fix that, and then like the weird stuff in the real world where it comes to like JJ coming in like mega late in the project. I get that. I'm not trying to use that as a buffer when I think about how ridiculous it was, because it was super ridiculous. And one of my favorite things is to point out how movies are ridiculous. But every movie has some problems. This had a lot of problems, but I still had a lot of fun. I thought it was good.
You're like, every movie has problems. This movie had a lot of problems. It's okay, though. It sounded like a Trump speech. Like, this movie's got a lot of problems. Movie's got problems. Lots of movies got problems. This movie got problems.
It's got a lot of problems.
But I like this movie, though.
A lot of problems.
Even though it's got problems, I like the movies
that got problems. On Twitter.
Dude, at the end of the day, right, we can't really blame anyone but the people behind.
Yes, there's a lot of people you can blame. You blame the Disney executives who show up to the set and they say, no, this isn't working, change this.
There's no one, we can't really blame the actor. You can't really even say this is JJ's fault. This is Kathleen Kennedy and the execs at Disney.
We're calling full names. We're calling full names out.
They thought going into a trilogy without a script, without a plot, without a whole like, plot
without
line,
any thought process.
Any thought process was going to be a creative like masterpiece, and it ended up being a complete joke.
They said we're banking off the franchise name. The fans will come through no matter what we put out.
And for what it's worth, like if you read Duel of the Fates, Colin Trevorrow's film, it was 10 years after The Last Jedi, and it could have maybe still been an interesting trilogy, but we paid fan service, and now we just have this crap. But
that reminds me of something I said a while ago. I sound like Luke now. I said this once, but when when Disney bought the rights to Star Wars, it was right after they made Avengers, and everyone was like, oh no, they're gonna ruin it. I was like, guys, they made Avengers. Avengers was amazing. They're just gonna like pump a bunch of money into it and let people who love Star Wars do their thing.
Make it.
Disney, I know I just spent an hour trying to defend Rise of Skywalker, but y'all kind of dropped the ball on this, guys. Just let the nerds make the movie. Stop ruining
it. Be better, Disney.
I vouch for you. To all the other nerds, All of them.
Don't.
They all
don't
died
for a very
old
long
people.
Time.
Don't let old people decide like what goes.
Yeah, it's so crazy. But Disney specifically does that a lot. It's like, why can't you guys just fund the movie? Just give us the money and let us make it.
Yeah.
That's what you hired us for, to make
the
movie.
Here's the thing. In my notes, I wrote, this is probably the messiest film since Amazing Spider-Man 2. I'm thinking about Amazing Spider-Man 2. I think this film is more messy than Amazing Spider-Man 2.
I think so. From what I remember,
how I want to end with this.
Like, Amazing Spider-Man 2, granted, was messy.
That's
where
I want to end, dragging Spider-Man.
But at least I understood the plot of Amazing Spider-Man 2.
Oop.
I left with more questions in this movie. But
yeah,
anyway.
I did leave with a lot of questions.
All right, let's wrap this up, guys. This is going to be the longest podcast we've ever done.
Oh, really? My goodness.
Wow.
Surprising,
I think so.
Actually.
I think so. Let's do plugs. Welcome back to the podcast, everybody.
I hope you didn't.
Shayne,
like, yes,
start with
still,
you. But I gotta
if
go.
You're
I gotta
still
drink a
in.
Glass of water.
I've been drinking water this whole time.
Maybe a
stay
beer,
hydrated. That's my plug. Please stay hydrated. Please stay clean. Please stay healthy. And while you're doing that, you can follow me on Instagram, which is Mr. McCatty, MrMcCatty. And you can listen to my podcast while you're washing your hands for 20 plus seconds, which is the Pop Talk Podcast, talking about pop music and pop culture. And just search Pop Talk Podcast and you will find that. So yes, stay safe, y'all.
Woo. All right, Nick.
I love Drummond, no G. I love Drummond, no G at the end. You can follow me on YouTube, Twitter. What else am I on? Facebook. I'm trying to remember. There's one more. Oh, Instagram. Sorry. I forgot about that one. It's been weird.
The most important one.
I'm trying to do other stuff other than be on social media. So
yeah,
I just forget like what I'm doing. But I feel like my hands, there's so much rubbing alcohol and hand sanitizer on these guys. They feel drunk, dude. It's crazy.
They feel drunk.
Stay safe. Like, wash your hands. Don't touch your face. Love you all. Bye.
All right, Michael.
All right, I got a couple of things, actually. So just follow me on Instagram, MYKOLDIMAS. It's Michael Dimas. I'm doing guitar lessons online. Just shoot me a message on Instagram if you're interested. I do have a quarantine special. You get four lessons up front. You get one lesson for free. So check it out. There's more details on my page. Also, go to YouTube after listening to this podcast, or once you get home, look up Backstroke of the West. The Backstroke of the West is Star Wars Episode 3 translated into Chinese and then back into English. The Backstroke of the West is actually what it translates Revenge of the Sith as. So I just want to read a couple of quotes real quick. I'll give you some context and I'll tell you what they said. So this is
I've seen some of this actually.
This is Obi-Wan saying, "It's over, Anakin. I have the high ground." And Anakin's like, "You underestimate my power." And Obi-Wan goes, "Don't try it." Also, guys, that's from memory. I don't even have that quote in front of me. But then they call Obi-Wan's name is Ratio Tile. And Anakin's name is Abba Gold. So it's Ratio Tile.
Abba Gold.
Everything ends the peaceful is willing to. The geography that I stands compares to you superior. Abba Gold. You underestimate my... You underrated my ability. Radio Tile. Is. That's it.
You underrated my abilities.
There's dialogue. Like, it's not just subtitles. They are saying these things. And you can
know what?
Okay, like when
that's what the lines in this feel like.
When Darth Vader comes off of the
we have to wrap up. We have to wrap up.
Darth Vader comes out off of the chair at the end of episode 3 when he's like, "You killed Padme in your rage." Or in your rage, you killed her. He gets up. He's like, "No!" And this movie, he goes, "Do not want." And it's amazing. Go to YouTube. Watch Backstroke of the West. They have the full movie. So they also have a highlight.
Do not want.
They also have a highlight clip. It's like a 30-minute condensed version of episode 3. So if you know the scene, the dialogue of episode 3 pretty well, it'll be even better. But it's really funny.
So funny.
Super great. Go check it out.
All right. So you can follow me on Instagram at Luke Roxwell. That's LukeRoCksWold. We did this episode live for part of it. It ended up cutting off after an hour. So yeah, that's cool. Guys, we're all in the same boat. Is back. Good to have everyone here. Thanks for listening. And
out. 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 Out.